In today's MTG Box Analysis, we're going to take a look at the set distribution versus the cards observed in this Core Set 2019 Booster Box. We'll then take a look at set coverage, coverage by rarity, duplication, set value, as well as the value observed in this box for non-foils, foils, and we'll break it down by rarity. Then we'll close things out with a summary of the box opening. If you want to go deeper into the analysis and see all of the metrics for this box plus at least 80 others, simply join the channel at the Give Me the Data level. Let's take a look at how this box was distributed across the set. This chart shows the foils that we saw in orange, the non-foils we saw in green, and the set in gray as the baseline. Within the non-foil space, we saw a variance of 9 cards between the primary colors of Magic, with white having the least at 82, and blue and green being tied for the most with 91. In the foil space, we saw 8 cards, which is 1 in every 4.5 packs. The only categories where we didn't see a foil were in black and artifact. In this booster box, we saw 240 unique non-foil cards, which accounts for about 86% of the 280 cards we were eligible to see. Our highest coverage among the primary colors of Magic was in blue, with 88% of the cards making an appearance in this box. Being an older set, foils weren't as prevalent as they are today, and as such, we only saw 8 foils in these 36 packs. This gave us 3% coverage of the 280 cards in the set. Our highest coverage overall was in the non-basic lands, with 2 of the 13 cards being present for 15% coverage. Pivoting to coverage by rarity, in this box we saw 100% of the commons and 95% of the uncommons. We also saw 31 unique rares for 58% coverage and 4 mythics for 25% coverage. In the foil space, we saw 4 commons, 2 uncommons, and a single mythic. In this box, we saw 250 unique cards, which means that 290 of the cards were duplicates. This gave us a duplication rate of 54%, which is 2% more than we saw in the Core 2020 and Core 2021 booster boxes. In total, we saw 55 playsets of common cards in the box, and 3 of the commons were seen 6 times. Before we dive into the value that we saw in this box, let's take a look at the set value using non-foil pricing. Currently, the Core Set 2019 features 6 cards valued over $10. Some of them include Sarkhan Fireblood, valued at $10.72, Crucible of Worlds, valued at $21.28, Nicol Bolas, the Ravenger, valued at $22.70, Scapeshift at $25.55, and the Resplendent Angel at $33.98. There's also 1 card valued between $5 and $10, and 24 cards valued between $1 and $5. The remaining 249 cards in the set are valued less than $1. If you were to add up the value of all 280 cards in the set, you'd end up with $226.95. Now let's take a look at the value that we saw in this box, starting off in the non-foil space. We did see 1 of the 6 cards valued over $10, which was the Omniscience, valued at $10.51. We also saw the only card in the set valued between $5 and $10. We saw 15 cards valued between $1 and $5, but the remaining 513 cards in the box were valued less than $1. In the foil space, we saw 8 total cards. One of them, the Reliquary Tower, was valued between $5 and $10. In fact, it was valued at $5.67, which is 1.8 times more valuable than its non-foil counterpart. We also saw 1 foil valued between $1 and $5, but the remaining 6 foils in the box were valued less than $1. Now let's break down the value that we saw in this box by rarity. The 5 mythics we saw account for 18% of the total box value. The 32 rares account for 24% of the total box value. But the 110 uncommons account for the largest percentage of the box, with 30%. The commons account for 14%, the lands account for 2%, and the tokens account for 5%. So how did this box perform? Well, I purchased this box from Card Kingdom for $129.99. However, I did use trade, so it only cost me $100 in card value. This booster box contained 36 packs with 15 cards each, giving us a total of 540 cards plus tokens. The 38 tokens in the box are valued at $6.69. The 8 foils were valued at $10.92. The 530 non-foils in the box are valued at $99.08. This brings the grand total up to $116.69, and it does mean that we did see a loss of $13.30, and only 90% of the box price being returned in card value. For those of you interested in cards valued just over $2, the numbers look like this. In total, we saw 14 cards valued over $2, and they have a total value of $60.98, which is 52% of the total box value. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, do something amazing.